Dear students, in this video you will learn about nootropics. Nootropics are nothing but, in another name, cognition enhancer cerebroactive drugs. So nootropics, in simply you can tell it as smart drugs. So let us move introduction. So what is cognition? Cognition is nothing but, this is the mental process which helping to gain knowledge and by that way comprehension, means understanding. If somebody is gaining knowledge and has command to comprehend it, means understanding power, then that is perfect cognition. Okay. So mere gaining knowledge is not called as cognition. So cognition is nothing but gaining knowledge with comprehension, means understanding. So for this reason, cognition will include four things. Number one is thinking, number two is knowing, number three is remembering, and fourth is judging. So to get something, you should to get some knowledge or to have the cognition, you should have the capacity to think and have the capability of knowing that what are you going to do, and by that way whatever you planned you should be remembered, and you can judge that one, that work. So next is cognitive enhancers or cerebroactive drugs. So let you know little bit about cognitive enhancers or what are the cerebroactive drugs. So these are heterogeneous group, means different types of groups of drugs are there, which is developed for the use of dementia, means memory loss, and other cerebral disorders, means along with memory loss any other cerebral disorders which may affect learning system. Then one next topic, what is dementia? So dementia refers to acquired global impairment of intellect. Global means total. Okay. Total impairment means disbalance of the intellect, means intelligence and memory and personality. That is altogether called as cognitive functions. Then second point, memory capacity to solve problems of day-to-day living and performance of learned motor skills, means if you are learning something and physically you are showing that one, that is called as motor skills. And social skills means your behavior towards society, how you are handling the society or persons in a society with your social skills. And control of emotions are primary affected. So these are the things which are related to memory, okay, and cognition, which will all affected by dementia, okay, memory loss. Then next is cognitive enhancer and its indication. So cognitive enhancers, these are nothing but neuroactive substance, or you can say drug, that elevates, means improve individual's cognitive abilities, means learning capacity, okay, memory capacity, memory power. It is improving the cognitive enhancers or drugs in meaningful and sustained way, means in perfect and workful way. Okay, then if you divide this word into two, then it will come as new and tropic. So new means mind and tropic means bend or turn. So by the help of cognitive enhancers, you can turn your mind towards sharpness, okay, towards memory, means cognitive power. So for that reason it is called as nootropics. Okay, so pharmacological name of cognitive enhancers are nothing but nootropics. So how does it improve cognitive power? Means how it is improving the memory. So little of the mechanisms of these drugs, we can tell it in 4 points. Number one is increasing cerebral blood flow. So already there mentioned that if cognitive function or memory loss is occurred, dementia is occurred, then it will due to the damage in cerebral blood flow towards the brain. Means what are the blood are flowing through blood vessels in the brain, so those may be affected. So if increasing cerebral blood flow, that then dementia may be stopped. Okay, so we need to increase the cerebral blood flow. So what is cerebral blood flow? So cerebrum is the major part of the brain, okay, which is a bigger part, and it is of two parts, means left hemisphere and right hemisphere. Okay, so foldings are there in that region. Okay, so outer major bigger part is that called cerebrum. Okay, then second is enhancing neurotransmissions. Means whatever the neurotransmitters are there which are responsible for cognitive function or memory, those neurotransmissions should be properly enhanced. So by these drugs, nootropics, it could be enhanced. So third point is increase neuronal metabolism. So if proper neurotransmitters functioning is going on, then metabolism of those neurons should be done. So increasing neuronal metabolism, if properly is working, then it will cause again that problem solving of the memory loss. Okay, then fourth point is increase nerve growth factor and increase cerebral functions. So this point here mentioning that nerve growth factor means whatever the factors are there which boosting the memory, that should be increased by the help of nootropics and increase cerebral functions, and by that way it is increasing the cerebral functions, that is nothing but memory. Okay, so main two types of neurotransmitters for memory and learning is there. Okay, so which enhancing neurotransmission, so these particular neurotransmitters are enhanced in the neurotransmission, that is acetylcholine and glutamate. So acetylcholine, this is responsible mainly for learning, and glutamate is mainly for memory. So acetylcholine in CNS, means central nervous system, it is responsible for thought, learning and memory, and it is also responsible for attention and awakening, okay, of our body system. So this is the major function of the acetylcholine. So already I kept this about neurotransmitters, all neurotransmitters all together at the last slide, so you can watch through that one. Okay, but we need these two functions, acetylcholine and glutamate. So first I already mentioned, the next one is glutamate. So glutamate is mainly responsible for memory, and which could improve learning and memory, and that regulates development and creation of nerve contacts. Means it is developing the learning capacity and memory, and by that way it is regulating development and creation of contact altogether, the nerves which are responsible for the memory. Okay, then if other problems is occurring, so by that way it may affect memory loss. So what are those? That those are nothing but indications of cognition enhancers, include number one, senile dementia. This is related to Alzheimer's type of dementia. Means in Alzheimer, already I taught you in previous video, you can go and watch that video later after completion of this video. So in Alzheimer's, means this is actually age related, old age related disease. Okay, so which is causing senile like plaque in the brain, means particularly in amygdala, okay, hippocampus. So in those region it is forming senile in the nerve endings. Senile means on plaque, like in blood vessels, if some cholesterol is deposited, so that is called as plaque. Okay, so due to that one, ischemic heart disease may caused. So here also in brain, senile plaque are formed due to nerve damage, nerve ending damage. Okay, so by that way, some amyloid protein, beta amyloid proteins, like those are deposited. Okay, in the ending of the nerve. And by that way, it is forming senile dementia of Alzheimer's type of disease. So that will cause dementia, because there is stopping the proper propagation of the nerve impulses from presynaptic nerve to postsynaptic nerve. And multi-infarct dementia, MID in short, you can tell, you can say. So what is this one? Means this is also called as multi-infarct dementia is also called as cerebrovascular accident. So it is nothing but in our brain totally there is blood supplying. Okay, so blood vessels are there which is supplying the blood towards each and every region of the brain. So that is called as cerebrovascular, and due to the cerebrovascular, and if due to cerebrovascular accident occurring, so damaging to that brain from interruption of its blood supply. So by that way, brain is damaged because interruption of its blood supply is occurring. Okay, because if that region of the brain is stopped from supplying of the blood, then it will cause that one MID, means multi-infarct dementia, means that is, in short, we can say stroke. Okay, so lack of blood supply to that particular region or to the brain region which is responsible for memory. Okay, so if it is stopped, so frequently, then that is called as cerebrovascular accident or stroke, and it is also called as multi-infarct dementia. Okay, so many times it is occurring. So next one is for responsibility of memory is main parts in the brain are amygdala, hippocampus, cerebellum and prefrontal cortex. So what is prefrontal cortex in four brain that is present? Okay, so entire is the cerebrum. So in front and below the front, that is four brain, that is called as prefrontal cortex. So these are the main region for the memory. Okay, so then second point is common symptoms of elderly. So this is dementia is related to elderly patients, so this is common for them only, and for children as well, but later I will discuss about that one. Okay, then it will cause dizziness and memory disturbance. Okay, so here nothing to explain, all is easy. Then third point is mental retardation in children. So if some children are having problem in memory, okay, like learning defects, attention deficit disorder, means not having proper attention to learn something. So some children you can observe, so those are having mental retardation. Okay, so because of this one, disturbances in the neuronal transmission. Okay, like acetylcholine and glutamate in the brain. Then fourth one is transient ischemic attacks. So ischemic attacks means due to plaque attacks are coming. Okay, then cerebrovascular accidents, that is stroke, already I explained on first point. Okay, so if you are not able to understand here what is cerebrovascular accident, then you can again listen the first point later. Okay, then fifth one is organic psychosyndromes, like syndromes which is occurring due to head injury, brain surgery, etc. So if someone is getting head injury or brain surgery, it will cause psycho syndromes, that is called organic psycho syndromes. So which may cause also dementia or memory loss. Okay, so this is all about how brain is functioning and how it is occurring. Okay, and what is the faults? What are the faults due to brain memory loss is occurring? Okay, so this is all about. So what will happen in multi-infarct dementia? This is very important point. That's why again I am telling that. So this is also called as already vascular dementia. Okay. So this will cause confusion in the person, trouble in paying attention and concentrating on some work, and reduced ability to organize thoughts or actions. So these will be effects if someone is getting multi-infarct dementia. Okay. So why this is happening? Already I told you, because of lack of blood supply to that particular region of the brain, okay, which is having acetylcholine and glutamate. So it is not able to proper functioning of the neurotransmission. Okay, so that's why this is happening. So then other functions will be defected, that is decline in ability to analyze a situation. So that person couldn't be able to analyze the situation, and difficulty in decision making, and what to do next. So these problems will occur because of the problems with memory. So this is all about the indications of cognition enhancers. Okay, then in next, what are the drugs used for this disorder to improve the memory? So these are the listed drugs. Number one is cholinergic activators. So you know that cholinergic nerve or neurotransmitters are the main neurotransmitter which is responsible for stimulation effect, so excitatory effect. Okay, so it will cause for periphery, it will cause muscle contraction, but like cholinergic activator, like acetylcholine is a main neurotransmitter, so excitatory effect in CNS will cause learning, will inboost the learning capacity. Okay, but in periphery it will cause contraction of the muscles. Okay, so cholinergic activators example, rivastigmine. So this is the drug which is cholinergic activator, so it will induce the acetylcholine normal functioning. Okay, by that way it is useful for the cognitive function or as a nootropic agent. So what is the mechanism of this one? So it is anticholine stress inhibitor, means the enzyme which is responsible to degrade the acetylcholine release from presynaptic to postsynaptic or in synaptic cleft. So this enzyme is degrading the acetylcholine. So if that person is getting rivastigmine as a drug, so it will bind with the acetylcholine esterase, so it will deactivate that enzyme so that acetylcholine can reach to the postsynaptic nerve and work properly. So this is highly lipid soluble, enters brain easily, useful for Alzheimer's disease. So this is about cholinergic activators, rivastigmine. Okay, so this name in marketed name is Rivamar. Rivamar 1.5, 3 and 4.5 and 6 mg capsules are available. Okay, so dose is initially 1.5 mg BD means twice a day, then increase every 2 weeks by 1.5 mg per day up to 6 mg per BD, again bis a day means twice a day. Okay, then next is donepezil. So donepezil, another, this one is the cerebroselective and reversible anticholine stress, useful for many cognitive as well as in non-cognitive activities. So this is cerebroselective, means particular what region we should use, and this is reversible, it can be reversed. Okay, so this is also anticholine stress, useful for many cognitive and memory functions. Okay, then next, third one is glutamate. So this is also important. Why I didn't explain about a second point? Because this is cholinergic activators. okay, rivastigmine and donepezil, both are same, okay, the drug is different. So this is cerebral selective and that rivastigmine is not selective. So these two drugs are cholinergic activators. And third one is glutamate. So N-methyl D-aspartate, N-glutamate, NM, actually here mistaken, I have here I have to mention NMDA, not T. So this is nothing but N-methyl D-aspartate. So that is, in short, you can tell glutamate. So glutamate is the receptor and neurotransmitters, okay, which is responsible for excitation and which is responsible for memory boost inboostment. So already I mentioned previous slide, okay. So what is the use of glutamate? So this is mainly responsible for memory inboostment, okay. So glutamate is the excitatory neurotransmitter which is causing memory boostment, okay, which is improving memory. So example of this drug is memantine. So if due to some other substance or anything, if glutamate receptor is stopped or inhibited, so this drug memantine will stop that that third substance to work glutamate properly, okay. So you can say that NMDA receptor antagonist has been found to slow the functional decline in moderate to severe AD. So it is declining the Alzheimer disease, means dementia, okay. So in mild dose, in milder disease, this is not clear what will happen, okay. So it also block excitotoxicity of the transmitter glutamate, means if glutamate is releasing more, then it may cause excitotoxicity, means again damaging of the nerve. So that also will be blocked, okay. So moderate release of that glutamate neurotransmitter should be done, so through memantine it could be possible. Understood? Then next one is fourth, other drugs, means which are not coming on these categories. So in separately it has kept these drugs are kept here. So number one is piracetam and pyretinol and pyrimidine and ginkgo biloba. So these are all drugs which can improve the neurotransmitters release and their control release and their degradation, okay. So by that way memory loss will be stopped. So next is the cholinesterase inhibitor neurotransmission, how it is occurring. So cholinesterase inhibitors like rivastigmine. So this is binding with anticholinesterase, which is rounded up with green. That is called, and that is I have mentioned here anticholinesterase. So that rivastigmine is binded with that anticholinesterase. So it will not cause to degrade the acetylcholine, which is releasing from presynaptic nerve to post synaptic cleft, then binding with the receptor on the postsynaptic receptor, so which is causing the normal function of the brain, that is memory inboostment, okay. Then other related functions. So if it is binding, rivastigmine is binded with acetylcholine stress, so it is inactivated by the rivastigmine. So by that way mechanism of the acetylcholine will be improved, okay. Then here different types of neurotransmitters and their functions I have mentioned here, like adrenaline, fight or flight. So what are the functions? So you can pause the video and you can see all those things, okay. Then GABA for calming, acetylcholine for learning, glutamate for memory, endorphin for euphoria, okay. So these are all, and serotonin for mood, dopamine, pleasure. So all the remaining things I have mentioned here. So what are their functions? If releasing more, then what will happen? If stopping, then what will happen? So you can go through this entire slide by pausing the video. So thank you dear students. If you understood the video, then that is very good, and I hope so that you understood properly. If you didn't get anything, so unfortunately, then please comment below the comment box and let me know, and I will answer it as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Please share, subscribe and like. Okay, thank you, see you again.